students, welcome back to the physics class. We already started our second chapter motion in our previous classes. Okay, so we already learned some of the topics, distance, displacement, vector quantity and scalar quantity in the previous videos. So let's revise what is distance and displacement once more. First one is distance. Distance is the length of path traveled. Distance has only magnitude, no direction. So, it is a scalar quantity. So, what is displacement? Displacement is the straight line distance from initial point to the final point. It has both magnitude and direction. So, it is a vector quantity. Okay. So, let's see some of the problems related with distance and displacement. Okay. So, let's do a problem related with distance and displacement. Here, you can see a figure from your textbook. Okay, this is the path traveled by an object. Here, the object starts its motion from the position A and reaches the D. That is, A is the initial position and D is the final position. Okay, while starting its journey from A, first it reaches the position B, then C. After that, it reaches its final position D. Okay, so now we are going to find out the distance and displacement from this figure. Okay, so this is the table related with that figure. According to the table, now we are going to find out the distance and displacement. First, we are going to find out the distance while reaching B. Then we have to find out the distance at the positions C, D and when it is returning to the position A. So let's do it. From A to B, the distance traveled by the object is 60 meter. Okay, so that we can find out from this figure. From A to B, the distance traveled is 60 meter. Okay, while reaching B, it is 60 meter. Then what about the next position? We know that the object starts its travel from A, then reaches B, then it reaches the position C. So that is 60 meter plus 60 meter. From A to B 60, then B to C again 60. So what is the answer? 120 meter. So what is the next one? While reaching D. So, here we want to find out the distance of the object when it is reaches D. So, here we want to add 60 meter, 60 meter and 40 meter. So, 60 meter per 60 meter, 120 meter that we already find out. Then, 120 meter plus 40 meter. So, what is the answer? 120 meter plus 40 meter that is 160 meter. Okay. So, this is the object traveled by the distance while reaching D. Then what about it returning to A? While returning to A, it travels how many distance? Yes, 160 meter plus 100 meter. So 100 meter is the distance traveled by the object from D to A. So here we want to add the 160 meter plus 100 meter, that is the total distance. So what is the answer? 260 meter. Okay. So this is the total distance traveled by the object throughout the journey from A to D through B and C. So next we are going to find out the displacement traveled by the object while reaching B. So from A to B, what is the displacement? Yes. 60 meter. We already know displacement is the straight line distance between the initial position and the final position. So here while reaching B, the displacement is 60 meter. The next one, while reaching C, that is A to C, here the straight line distance is 80 meter. Okay. The next one, while reaching D, that is from A to D, here also we are considering the straight line distance, that is 100 meter. Okay. So the next one, while returning to A, that is here the initial and final position is same, that is A. From A to D is 100 meter, from D to A is also 100 meter. So here the displacement is 0. Okay. So if we are calculating the displacement, the initial point and the final point is the same. The displacement will be 0. Okay. So let's see the next question. Here is a triangular path. Okay. The object starts its journey from A and reaches C through B. The distance from A to B is 60 meter. From B to C is 40 meter. And from C to A is 80 meter. So let's see how can we find out the total distance and displacement here. Okay. Here the total distance, okay, traveled by the object from A to B, then B to C, and again it reaches A, that is from C to A. So we can consider the three values here: 60 meter plus 40 meter plus 80 meter. Okay, that means the object reaches to the same position after reaching C. So what is the answer? 180 meter. Okay. So next one is the displacement. We know the displacement is the straight line distance from the initial position to the final position. Okay. So while we are considering A as the initial position and C as the final position, for displacement, what is the answer? Yes, 80 meter. Okay, 80 meter. But here we are considering the journey of the object from C to A. That is, after reaching C, the object returns to the initial position A. That is, here the initial position and the final position is A here. Okay, that is, displacement from A to C is 80, but after reaching C it returns to the initial position. Okay, so what is the total displacement? Total displacement equals what? The distance from A to C, then C to A. Okay, distance from A to C, then C to A. So here A is the initial position and final position. So here the displacement will be 0 because the initial position and the final position is same here. So the displacement will be 0. Let's see another problem. Here it is a straight line path. The object starts its journey from A and reaches C through B. Okay. So from A to B, the distance traveled by the object is 60 meter. And from B to C, the distance traveled by the object is 40 meter. So here also we are going to find out the total distance traveled by the object and the displacement. Okay. So let's see how can it be done. Total distance, that is the distance traveled from A to B, then B to C, 60 meter plus 40 meter. What is the answer? Yes, 100 meter. Okay. Then what about displacement? Displacement is the straight line distance that we know, and here it is a straight line path. Here the initial position is A and the final position is C. Okay. And the object is not returning to the position A. So what will be the displacement? 60 meter plus 40 meter. That is 100 meter. That is, in a straight line path, the total distance and the displacement will be same. Okay. But in the second question, we see that the Object travels through a triangular path, okay, and the distance and displacement is different here, okay. So let us conclude this. For an object having a straight line path, the distance and displacement will be the same, okay. That is, the magnitude of distance and displacement will be equal only when an object moves along a straight line path, okay. In the second figure, the object moves along a straight line path, so here the distance and displacement is equal. So let's see what is the differences between distance and displacement. Distance is a scalar quantity. It is the length of path traveled. The magnitude will be equal or greater than displacement. But in the case of displacement, it is a vector quantity. And it is the straight line distance from initial point to the final point. Its magnitude will be equal or less than the distance. Okay, that means the value of the displacement is less than or equal to the magnitude of the distance. Okay, so these are the differences between distance and displacement. Okay, so I hope you all understood the content, okay. If you have any doubts related with this, you can ask me through the WhatsApp, and don't forget to go through the textbook. If you have any doubts related with this, you can ask me through the WhatsApp. Thank you for watching.